for refactoring the code as well, but they're trying to use this different structure because of the amount of time and performance they need in reducing the number of servers they need for the performance of PHP. So they're using off PHP in the back end, and that was becoming an obstacle as well. So it's these, and in also the Python case, there are two pieces. One is this is something called NumPy, which is basically for running blast. So there's a lot of numerically intensive computations now being done in PyPy. There's also the R language, if anybody's heard of, for data analytics, which is yet another interpreter and even more horribly implemented, though Revolution Analytics has a slightly improved implementation. So there's a lot of interest in the performance of these dynamic types of languages for where you're spending a lot of time in the computation in dynamic language itself. It's actually interesting because one of the things is there's sort of two different uses of R. In the traditional analytics space, they spend a lot of time in libraries in C or Fortran modules that are written for R. I mean, R basically uses sort of the I/O and has some nice reading in the original data for the display, and just then goes to the computation in like a random forest or some other computation library. But now the biotech groups are starting to use R for their analysis, and they're actually writing their code in the R language itself, which is a really, really, really horrible language. Horrible performance. And so now with that new user base, the performance of R itself is becoming much more critical. So, so just a lot of need for these, a lot of these languages are being pressed into more and more computationally intensive areas, and the performance of the languages themselves are becoming more important.
In that vein,
can you take it offline, Stan?
Okay.